Before we begin, all the links you need are in the description. Make sure to follow them carefully to avoid any errors. If you don't have it yet, download Aux MySQL. Usually, when creating a new server with the recommended setup, Aux MySQL is already included, just like in our previous server setup video. To download, click on Releases, then under Assets, choose Aux MySQL.zip. Download AuxLib. Aux Inventory requires AuxLib to function. To download, click on Releases, then under Assets, select AuxLib zip. Download Aux Inventory. To download, click on Releases, then under Assets, select Aux Inventory.zip. Download Aux Target, optional. For this tutorial, I'll be using it as well. To download, click on Releases, then under Assets, choose Aux Target.zip. For further documentation, please check the official website. Next, create a folder inside the server resource directory. I'll name it Aux and open the folder. Then, extract all the scripts you downloaded earlier into the Aux folder. Since Aux MySQL was already included in the previous server setup, I'll move it into the Aux folder for better organization. Here, I'm using Visual Studio Code to edit the scripts. Open Visual Studio Code, go to the File tab, select Open Folder, and locate your server's folder. Create a config.cfg file for both Aux Inventory and Aux Target. You can create the file directly in Visual Studio Code by right-clicking on the folder where you want to place the file, or you can use Windows File Explorer. Ensure the final format is not .txt. Once the config.cfg is created, go to the Aux Inventory documentation website, scroll down to the 5 config section, copy all the config settings, and paste them into config.cfg in Aux Inventory. Do the same for Aux Target. After creating the config.cfg, visit the Aux Target documentation website, and in the 3 config section, copy all the config settings and paste them into config.cfg in Aux Target. Next, open server.cfg and add setr, aux, n. Add ensure aux underscore lib above chat, and under the core, also add exec at aux underscore target slash config.cfg, exec at aux underscore inventory slash config.cfg, ensure aux underscore target, ensure aux underscore inventory. Remember, the script order matters, so follow it carefully. I'll also make a small change in config.cfg for Aux Inventory. In the setr, inventory section, set it to true to enable target usage. Finally, open, core, then ESXtended, and choose config.lua. Find the config.enable default inventory section and set it to false to disable the default ESX inventory. Okay, now open 5M for testing and start your server to see if the script installation was successful. Lastly, I'll remove scripts whose features are already included in Aux Inventory. Open ESX Add-ons, then delete ESX Shops and ESX Weapon Shop. That's it for this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and leave a comment if you have any questions. See you in the next video.